So I'm sure everybody's been to these screenings and then the question and answer session afterwards. So, by your loss, if we don't mind, we will lie.
Yeah, well, we all get the same as being outstanding, but I mean, you know, everybody's taller than me.
We got a question.
Doesn't he feel self-conscious?
It's the first we have a question, right?
I was going to do a little panel discussion.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry.
And then we'll open it up to the world. And I want to start with Sam. You're an award-winning documentary filmmaker and the co-founder of Banner Films. And you did the metal film, Headbanger's Journey, and the hip-hop series, which is called Hip-Hop Evolution. What drew you to do a documentary on CC Time?
I think we should stand on it.
He had just on board over me. Have the decency, you know.
Well, you know, the first time I saw ZZ Top, I was 9 years old, and I'm Canadian, so I saw them on Much Music, which is our equivalent of MTV. And you know, I never forget the moment I saw the videos off the Eliminator album, because it was like these bearded aliens had kind of landed in my living room, and I think like many other, you know, impressionable preteens, it made an immediate impact on me. But as the years went on and I got into music and then into filmmaking, I realized, I think like many others, that I knew next to nothing about this band and what preceded that moment. I think that MTV moment was so explosive for so many people. It was almost like it felt like a band without history for fans of a certain generation. So for us in making the film, I think it was just, how did that happen? How did they get to that point? And I think it was tough because, you know, part of the story is about mystique, and how do you tell a story about a band where mystique is like in the DNA? And so it was like one part storytelling, like three parts archaeology, I think, making the film. And so that was the motivation, because I think, you know, there's just with the band being around for 50 years now, there's a lot of curiosity as to how it all happened.
One more question for you, Sam. Why was it called ZZ Doc? Okay.
Come on, be honest. It's the car and the girls. Just say.
I think the name of the little band from Texas kind of chose us. I don't think there really could have been another title.
So Billy, yesterday on Eddie Trunk's SiriusXM show, you admitted that you hadn't seen the film, and you were waiting to see it on the big screen. There's no bigger screen than this. So what do you think?
I'm so I had to sit in the back. Someone said, "Oh, go down. You got the good seat." I didn't want to sit and have somebody looking at me while I was looking at me.
Well, is it okay?
It's wonderful. Okay. Actually, a big hand for Sam and his team. Thank you very much.
Billy, what is the footage of you cutting up in white Levi's? What do you have any context for it? You're coming out of a 65 Valiant, I think, and acting like a nun. Where was that shot? What was that about?
That was here in California.
Oh, really?
Yeah. The moving sidewalks came in 1968. We came down and played. There were two great spots down on the west end of Sunset. Gazzaris, somebody. Okay. In the galaxy, there was Pandora's Box and all that stuff. So, and we were having a good time. Still doing a good job.
And I noticed, Sam, that there's a shot of a strip with ZZ Top headlining the Whiskey. What year would that have been? Anyway, it'll be a dozen probably.
I have no idea. We may have faked it in the wrong spot.
Well, it was all about tour in Texas, and there's the Whiskey, but yeah, you know, it's just Sam. But
artistic license.
We liked it. It's very once upon a time, you know what I mean? Dusty, what kind of adjustments did you have to make to your approach with playing, coming from the American Blues to ZZ Top, aside from not doing hair or blue?
Well, before I got with Billy, almost all the bands I've been with were with my brother. And it was a really good guitar player, but very different than Billy. So I grew up in different circumstances, but I've heard of Billy for years and I never met him. You know, I played in Houston with Frank in different bands, kept hearing about this guy. And I think he was the only musician in town I had met. So I built that in my mind, you know, that, you know, he's really great or he's an asshole. I mean, you know, I didn't know which one.
There's a joke in there.
What I'm saying,
trying to work that out.
But what I'm saying is, for a change, I don't know, I guess it's for a change. The film's right. I mean, when we first played, Shuffling Seas, the only name of the song, it felt familiar because of Frank. And it felt familiar because of the strength that Billy had, I was used to with my brother, but it had that other thing that probably has no name. And I knew it right away. We just played, you know, I knew it within 30 seconds too. It just took us 3 hours because we didn't want to quit playing. I think my fingers were sore.
Yeah.
Speaking of playing, the live sequence said, I heard it, did you say Green Hall? Looks like a room to me, but it's Green Hall. I'm not from Texas. I don't think I have a room. And my question is, does that exist as a totality? Do you have a number of songs recorded in that circumstance?
There's more.
How many?
The number
of albums were?
The ones that we remember.
Yeah, I think we did 10-ish tracks that day. We shot over 2 days. We did the B-roll shots with the car the first day, and then the second day was an entire day of playing.
Well, the audio was fantastic. Here, of course, but even I watched the film on a laptop.
Well, I'm very fascinated. This guy was so intent on asking a question. Could we get
all right, let's
ask
the question.
First of all, I want to thank y'all for keeping the blues alive. I'm from the Kansas City area. I was born in blues. I'm born and bred on the blues. And blues brought me to you guys. My brother used to live in Laredo, Texas back in the 70s. Saw you in 1971 with Willie Nelson. I saw you on that Worldwide Texas tour at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. That blew my mind. I ain't been the same since.
As far as I can go, the same forever.
My main question is, how's Frank doing? Heard he's not?
Frank's doing well.
Good. He's coming along.
I hear something, but you know, he's a drunk.
That's right.
Now, when I say that, usually people just go, yeah. And I have no idea what that means. It's just, well, he's a healthy guy. No, he's doing great. He'll be right back with us.
You probably read the news report. Well, I read it. He had pneumonia. We think he's lying.
Good enough.
You want a day off, okay?
Is there another question from the
before I get another question, I want to call attention to the Queens of the Stone Age, my buddy John. Thank you, John. My buddy Billy Clark.
I've never been in one of these things, and I'd thought, well, great. Billy and I will be here. I'm not sure about past that.
Are you going to buy the whole audience a Coke?
I think we should give a shout out actually to a couple of other people who are here who were in the film. Firstly, legendary rodeo clown and animal wrangler, Ralph Fisher.
What other state sound would you define?
Wait, are you glad I picked on this town?
Yeah.
Thanks for slowing us up.
Yeah, right.
Well, listen, we want to thank everybody for coming out. It's been a great night. And,
Love you.